Welcome in the Red Bay Tiger Football Coach Show on the air with Red Bay Tiger Head Coach Michael Jackson. And your host for the Red Bay Tiger Football Coaches Show is Jack Ivey.
Well, hello again, and welcome into the Red Bay High School Football Coaches Show. Jack Ivey for another week. Got Coach Jackson to be joining us in just a second. And we always like to say on Mondays when we do the Coaches Show, another big win for the Red Bay Tigers. Tigers knocking off the Hatton Hornets on the road. Over 300 yards rushing in the game again for the Tigers, 373 total. Just an outstanding effort against a much improved Hatton Hornet Ball Club. We're going to bring in the coach and talk about the big win. And here he is, Coach Michael Jackson. Coach, big win.
We're very excited. We want to thank all of our fans that went over there. And I didn't realize until I was watching the film back how many people we had there.
Awesome.
And when I was watching the film back again, I knew it was kind of loud, but I get distracted. And I don't ever think about nothing else going on around the game. And when I was watching the film and our crowd was huge. So we want to thank everybody for going over there. And we needed that, too, because Hatton is a tough place to play. It's always been tough for us over there. 2 years ago, we barely got out of there, and I thought we had a lot better football team than them back then. So I knew it was going to be tough. Their kids were very excited. Hatton's community was very excited. It was a lot of – they put a lot of stuff on social media last week and about – the different streaks that we got going that they was going to, you know, going to try to stop. And so it was a lot of hoopla around that game. Probably one of the more intense games that we've had in a while as far as our kids being motivated to win this game, knowing we had to play really good on the road, knowing that we had different officials, knowing that we had an adverse environment that we hadn't played any well, and a team that's got some pretty good players and some really good guys inside. They had a defensive end and a couple guys on the defensive front that's good football players. So they gave us some problems throughout the night. But I was so proud of the way we played and the way the game kind of went. You know, they only had five first downs and 130-something yards, and they broke a long kickoff, or I think we would have had that game in hand a little quicker. They did a good job. Well, actually, both teams did a great job in the punt team. Dustin Burks for us and our snappers, Jesus Kelly, we pinned them inside the 10 twice. And it was a big thing in the second half. But they pinned us inside the 5 twice in the first half. And that really killed a couple of our drives, our possessions. Overall, just a great atmosphere to play in. Our seniors, this is the I told them after the game, I was so proud of them because they showed a lot of heart, a lot of leadership in this. This game took a lot out of them, and they showed great leadership in the victory. And but both everything that we did, the running game, the offensive line blocked well, big time stuff from Kobe, a couple great passes there right before the half. That was so big to take the ball right down the field. And you know, Jesus had a big night, and Max Bullen had two big catches there, and on nice throws. So we did some good things in the passing game. Always some good things in the rushing game. Tate's going to get what he gets. And I think he ended with over 150 yards, but he ran so hard that, it takes a lot out of the defense when we get into that short yardage offense and are able to just keep the ball and run over you. So we did a good job with that in our short yardage offense. But Coach Percy did a great job, and him and Coach Majerese, Coach Tuberfield did a great job with our defensive our alignments and what we're trying to stop, because we pretty much had them pegged at what they were trying to do. They hit us on one or two little passes there, but they got good players. You know, and they got good players too, and they're going to make their plays. But so the effort overall, I was very pleased with, and that's probably one of the best, most complete game. I know it this year, the most complete game we played as far as intensity, both sides of the ball, everybody into the game, and taking everybody to win.
If you just happen to tune in, you're watching, of course, the Red Bay High School Football Coaches Show. We're going to get into those highlights because we got a lot of great highlights. But, Coach, I knew since I've been broadcasting Red Bay football that the Hornets had not beaten the Red Bay Tigers, but I didn't know exactly how far the streak went back. But 1987 is the last time.
Right.
And that takes you way on back. So.
Yeah, it does. And the papers built it up a good bit, too. But pretty much we're getting everybody's best game. And that's the way it's going to be, because we've got multiple streaks on the line. We've got the longest streak in the state of Alabama on road wins. Now it's 16. We got the third longest winning streak regular season at 22 games. So, you know, I tell everybody this all the time. This is more motivation for our opponents than us.
It is us, right.
Our kids don't think about it too much. But everybody we play, they are. And they're wanting to be the ones that stop that. So they're very excited for it.
You mentioned something about the loud crowd. Normally at home, I'm inside the press box. I know we got a big crowd, but even though I got the windows up,
right,
I can't really tell how loud it is. But Friday night, I'm with the Red Bay Tiger crowd in the stands. It's open. And I'm going to tell you what, the band is playing loud. The Tiger fans are loud. And it just made a great night for football over in Hatton. And we enjoy the trip over. We always enjoy the trip over there. And even though the rivalry is intense, they're always very nice to us as far as when we're over setting up.
Right.
But we appreciate the hospitality, and we appreciate always getting a big win when we go over there as well. So, Coach, Tigers made it out. Y'all came over to the sideline with, a big game. And, of course, we get the football first. They won the toss, but we...
They actually took the ball first. That's the first time we've had a kick.
I don't know why I said that.
That's the first time we've had a kick. We usually take the ball. And defensively, we do a good job right here, coming out really strong. And just a great defensive performance from our front guys are getting better and better. Dustin Burks, Kirtland Heiser, Elijah Engel, and Joseph Newell doing a great job. Of course, our linebackers are our two leading tacklers from last year, so those guys are getting better and better and doing the things they need to do. And force a punt right here. Try to get on the board with we want to stretch them out some. Even if they stop the jet sweep, we want to stretch them out and have a little bobble snap right there. But Jesus has a big night off his little jet fake. And, of course, anytime we can get Caleb in the open field, you know, we want to do it. And, you know, how much confidence you got is, you know, we went for it on 4th and 2.
More than once.
More than once. And one time inside our own 20-yard line. So that was, we just had some confidence in what we were doing, or I wouldn't have done that.
How long did you have to think about it?
Not very long. I felt like we had a good situation with the play we was going to call. Great throw and catch right here between Max and Kobe, and good job finding that underneath the drag route. We get a holding penalty right there, and that kind of hurt that drive. Without that penalty right there, I think it's 2nd and 2, and I think we go ahead and score right there. Jesus comes in, does a great job. Had over 100 yards rushing. This is one of his little plays off of quarterback power. We end up having to throw it up on 3rd down, and I really don't know what happened here because they knock our receiver down. And nothing come of it. I don't know if I couldn't tell on film if this is a play right here, if he just ran into him or what. But I couldn't never tell what happened. But I know Jesus got knocked down somehow. Good job by Jesus snapping and Burks kicking. That punt team is so important, especially when you got two good defensive teams. Little quarterback comes out the backside of that versus field. I was impressed by how big they were up front. They had some pretty big guys up front that blocked really well. Great tackle right there by Caleb, and they get back on that fumble. But that was one of their passes they hit us on, a little seam route. They got a big tight end, does a good job for him. Number 2 right there, and he's a good size kid. I didn't know how big he was until I stood up beside him, and he's ever been a 6'4", about 230, and he does a good job for them. I think Elijah got held on that play. Little outside zone here. We're trying to keep him in front of us and force a long 3rd down, but I think we was in cover 2 right there, and they kind of got the seam on us. Still think it's 3rd and about 10 right here. And there were some weird things went on in that game as far as they had some offsides penalties and hold them up right here and get them short. And then they got a delay of game, and for some reason somehow we declined the penalty. I don't know. I asked him who declined it, and they couldn't tell me. I was excited and declined it. But that's what got ruled anyway.
End of the first quarter, the Red Bay Tigers and the Hatton Hornets on the Coach's Show here.
And they get us backed up right here. Like two series in a row, they get us back inside our five. And you don't want to make a mistake right here because you don't want to give them no momentum. So we basically had to try to get it out of there the best we could and take our chance. And Burks does a good job punting right here and just kind of put it back on our defense. Don't try not to give them too short of a feel. Great tackle right there by Drew Nix and Andrew Richardson. Great play on the screen pass right here by Jesus. Jesus is awesome. Doing a great job for us. Good job of the whole interior right there. Great job of Dustin Burks right there. Dustin's getting better and better on the defensive front wise, and we're going to have him play well. Then they turn right around and punt it inside our 10 again. We have a shot right here to take a little shot at a pass, and it's going to be real close. It would have been a good catch by Max, just off his fingertips. It would have been a big play for us, and we hit that later on in the game.
Of course, Max had three big catches in the game for 62 yards and two of them on that one drive.
Right. Good job, a little reverse play right there, too. Him and Jesus do a good job on that little play.
Well, we got fourth and a couple of inches or
fourth and a couple of inches, and we need to go for that, and we do. I'd hate to miss that, though. It'd been hard to explain. Right. Fourth and one for the 18.
Any doubt on the quarterback sneak?
Great job. Yes, the quarterback sneak. Great job by Jesus right here. This is all the news channels the other night, too, and going 80 yards. And great job on the quarterback power coming out the backside of it. And that's a big-time play for us. And everybody ought to know it's coming because we run it with him. Five or six times last game, and I think we ran it eight times the other night. So it's just hard to. He's so good at seeing the hole. It doesn't matter if you play the play because he's usually going to go a different place anyway. But great job by him. Abdul is ready for the extra point. It's up. Good. I think we're one for two in our extra points the other night, and we got to get a little consistent. A little bit more consistent with that. And this right here kind of, we've been doing a really good job on our kickoff team. And Max does a great job chasing this guy down right here. Actually forcing a fumble and the ball goes out of bounds. That really gave them some momentum. I thought we had them kind of backed up. And
I looked at that again, slowed it down a little bit. See if it got out, but...
Well, I think he ended up being late on the ball out of bounds, but you're right. I can't tell really from there.
See, there's the ball there. So,
but we gave him a short field, and they're able to – it took them a few plays there, but they was able to get it in, I think, on fourth down. But defensively, just a really good job by the defensive front linebackers and Blake Hester and Jesus Kelly, our outside linebackers.
Actually, that was fourth down there, and they blew the whistle and got the timeout. So they actually ran a fourth down play, but they had blown it dead. And, of course, after the timeout, they did score there. So
we get the ball right back. Probably the best drive of the year, in my opinion. Three or four big catches right there on the seam route by Max. But we got like 2 minutes to go, and we drive right down the field. Kobe does a great job looking the safety off and coming back. Max makes a big time catch and getting down to 10. Then we're gonna roll right here and hit Jesus in the back of the end zone. Just a great job by our offensive guys with that drive, and it was really big because it was the last drive of the half because we didn't have but a minute left, and then we got the ball in the second half. So we got to run some clock. I think there's like 54 seconds left. Tate does a great job of getting a two-point conversion. So just a really, really mature drive for our offense.
And what did that do? Put us up like 14-7 at halftime and stuff. Red Bay Tiger marching band playing at halftime over at Hatton the other night. Once again, if you're watching the Red Bay High School Football Coaches, you don't forget the coaches shows are always on Monday nights at 6:30. That's followed, of course, by the game replay. And we give you several opportunities to watch it. And don't forget, if you'd ever like to get a copy as a keepsake, you can contact us here at the studio.
Second half, we're going to really do a good job second half with taking care of the football and taking as much time off the clock as we can, too, and kind of not giving them a chance to get back in a game.
We had so many really nice drives against each other in that first half. I put a lot of the highlights in that first half and just show us scoring here in this particular drive. But I got to ask you a question here in a minute whenever we get to a particular play.
All right. Kobe does a good job on quarterback sneak. Of course, we've always done good on quarterback sneak. Troy did that last year. And, you know, Kobe's a pretty big kid, you know, 6'2", 185, 190. He's real good in the weight room, real strong. When he gets low, it's kind of hard to stop him from getting a yard or two.
Was this really an onside kick?
No. Great job by Caleb, though. I mean, that was an unreal play he made. And when I got it from the other angle, from the other side, you can see really what kind of play he makes on this ball. And I think Jesus is just trying to kick it over to the right side. And, you know, Jesus does a little bit of everything for us. And he's trying to push it over their heads, and it comes off the side of his foot a little bit. And you couldn't kick it no better than what he did, though, as far as onside kick. Now, what we're going to tell everybody is
that's great onside.
It was planned because that way everybody the rest of the year think we're going to onside kick, and we hadn't onside kicked in 2 years. And great job by Kirtland Heiser right here, getting the safety and really getting a lot of momentum right there. We kind of took their heart away from them right there. And
we're pumped at this point, Coach.
Yeah, we're very excited here. And then you just keep pounding away in our bone set, and we're gonna pop one sooner or later. And that's what Tate usually does. When we wear them out and they get tired, you see Andrew Ray and Andrew Richardson, both our linebackers in there, the power backs, and we just keep running at you. Great job by Burks and Hunter Tyler. And Jesus Kelly is our tight end on the right side, and he's probably the best blocking tight end that I've ever had in that bone set. He just does a great job with that. So our kids are very confident when we're getting that offense.
Coach, big win. I noticed I'm going to go back to that not onside kick, but it looked like we'll take her back in here, Keith. But I noticed that whenever he mispooched it or whatever you want to call it or whatever, I was really impressed with the guys on the kickoff team on that right side. They noticed it immediately.
Right.
And, boy, I'm talking about they took off after it and was able to recover it before it got out of bounds. So just a great effort by the special teams there, Coach.
Well, like I said, the view from the other press box is the view that we got. And Caleb lays out for that ball. How he got it before it went out of bounds, I'll never know. But he done a great job making a play on the ball.
You're watching, of course, the Red Bay High School Football Coaches Show. Jack Ivey along with the world-famous Coach Michael Jackson. Coach, I want to say we really appreciate you spending time with us here in Red Bay. Well, are you having a good time in Red Bay?
I'm having a great time. We're working to get better, and I was real proud of our team the other night. And you know, you asked the kids to play hard and lay it on the line, and they knew how important it was. And like we said before, we're getting everybody's best game. And that's going to happen. And these guys are fighting. We've got some guys that's getting better and better because this is the first time they played. So, you know, we're excited about going forward. We're excited about being off this week and getting everybody well again. And then it's going to be a tough stretch run there. Belmont's going to be a war in a couple weeks. And I know they're excited about it. They happen to be off this week, too. So both teams got an off week. And we'll go scout some guys that we're going to play later on. But you know, that's going to be a huge game over there. I think they're going to carry that game on that TV station that carried it last year.
Right.
From what I understand. So, and Belmont's played some really good games this year and had some real close games. So, I know their kids are always excited to play our kids. And, you know, I just know that atmosphere is going to be crazy.
No doubt.
And so our guys have got to prepare and work for that wing tee offense. Good thing is we've seen it a couple weeks ago.
Right.
So it may help us out kind of preparing for it. But, you know, we're going to have a big-time game over there with them and then come home for homecoming the next week A big game tonight with Tharptown on our JV game. So if you get a chance to come out tonight on Monday night, 6 o'clock, to watch our JV play, a lot of those guys are playing on Friday night. So you need to, you know, come out and see those guys if you get a chance.
Stats for the ball game before we look at our Spirit Award winner for the week. Bragwell had 4 completions for 73 yards and a touchdown. On the rushing side, we had 51 carries in the game for 300 yards, 3 touchdowns. Osborne, 30 carries for 152. He had a touchdown. Bullen had 1 for 5. Kelly had 6 for 112. He had an 80-yard touchdown scamper there. Burroughs had 4 for 9. Bragwell, 7 for 12. Louis had 3 for 10. And once again, the Red Bay Tigers, 51 carries, 300 rushing yards, 3 touchdowns. And Bullen, 3 big catches for 62 yards. And Kelly had 1 for 11 for the touchdown on that drive that was described by a coach as the best drive we've had in a while there.
Yeah.
2 awesome catches there by Bullen and an awesome catch for a touchdown by Kelly. And Red Bay had 10 penalties in the ball game. We had 1 turnover, a fumble. Heiser had the safety, number 52, for the Red Bay Tigers. Burroughs had the interception. And also, I think, which was big time, was recovering that onside kick. So, once again, the Tigers coming out victorious, 30-7, against the Hatton Hornets. Still no band member this week, so we're going to go straight to the Spirit Award winner for the week for the Red Bay Tiger cheerleaders. And that Spirit Award winner this week is Carly Humphreys. Carly Humphreys, the winner of the Tiger Spirit Award winner. And I'll tell you what, these young ladies, they worked together with the band and the football team and the fans and the team to make it a very fun Friday night. And that's exactly what they did Friday night, getting all the folks pumped up. And congratulations on a great job by the Red Bay Tiger cheerleaders. Once again, your Tiger Spirit Award winner is Miss Carly Humphreys, and we appreciate them. Coach, I know you said we got an off week this week. You gave the team a little time off this week. What do we do this week
with the week off? We modify our schedule a little bit. We don't have to bring them in on the weekend, and we kind of have a film day. And so they get to have a little bit, not a normal game week. And plus they get to go out. Those guys like going out and watching people play on Friday night that we're going to play later on. And there's a bunch of region games that we're going to go watch this week. So, you know, it was a good time. We've been having our off week later on in the year, which I think is beneficial also. But it's just cordoned on to when you get it and how your team and what kind of shape they're in. And I was telling them the other day, the weather's been so hot. It's been really, for the last 6 weeks, a grind each and every day because usually we have hot weather a couple days a week, and then one day it'll be cooler, and they don't have to go out in that weather every day. And but the last 6 or 7 weeks, our kids have took a beating the whole week because the weather never gets that much better. So, you know, we're excited about probably the next time we play, it's going to be better weather. It'll be getting closer to fall. So, you know, we take some time this week. We'll prepare for the next couple teams we're playing and get everybody well.
Of course, Coach, we only got about a minute. Say something about our trainer. I noticed the other night when she takes care of them boys on the sideline, and I guess the funniest thing I've seen over there, I don't know where it was, Max had a cramp over there, and he was a little bit too close to the field. And, of course, I know Max was probably in some pain, and they're probably wanting to get she just slid him on over to the side a little bit.
Nikki does a good job, and, you know, Max was cramping a little bit. And, usually those guys that's in really good shape is the ones that we have a problem with. Max is in great shape, and plus he has no body fat on him, so he cramps because he runs a lot. And, yeah, she just drug him off the field. We have a thing we don't like. We try to get our kids off the field, and that's the kind of the mindset. And we knew he was cramping.
Oh, yeah.
We knew he wasn't had another injury, or we wouldn't have been dragging him off the field. But
she does a great job, doesn't she?
Yeah, she does a great job with that. And we appreciate everything she does. And it takes a lot to football is a very physical sport, and you've always got guys banged up. And she does a good job with it.
Coach, great job. A week off. Then we got the Belmont Cardinals on the road down at Belmont. And, of course, we'll be there, of course, covering that action. We'll have the Red Bay crew and the Belmont crew both there that night covering Red Bay Tiger and Belmont Cardinal football. So, Coach, appreciate you again. Appreciate the great job you do. Appreciate you, coaches and players and fans. So we'll see you in a couple of weeks down in Belmont. For Keith, I'm Jack Ivey saying thank you for joining us for the Coaches Show. Don't forget the replay is coming up, of course, always after the Coaches Show. And we'll see you next week right here on TV 12, TV 97, with your hometown station. Y'all have a great day.
You've been watching the Red Bay Tiger Football Coaches Show with head coach Michael Jackson, your host for the Tiger Football Coaches Show, Jack Ivey. Stand by. Tiger football coming up.